Hello, Anshita. Welcome to Portal People. And first and foremost, wishing a very happy belated birthday. So how did the day go?
How did the birthday go? Oh, birthday went actually working. Mm-hmm. I was working and it was a nice working birthday. Mm-hmm. It was very tiring though, but good one.
So, you know, as you said that, you know, you have been working for quite some time during the pandemic. And you also dubbed for Mirzapur's second season. So I want to know from you that what behavioral patterns were related to work you have observed in these times?
People are keeping distance. Hugs have changed into fist pump and all that. Mm-hmm. And masks are on, but we have to... But yeah, it's just that you've become more finicky about cleanliness. Like, okay, yes. Has this been sanitized? Are the earphones sanitized? Mm-hmm. Or maybe sometimes you're carrying your own earphones.
Yeah.
Yeah, all that is there. But mm-hmm. yeah. That's the new way. It's mm-hmm. normal.
And so in the first season of Mirzapur, if I divide the series into two equal halves of black and the white, Kalin Bhaiya and Munna, these are the two characters that reside in the dark space, while Guddu and Bablu, they are on the borderline of grey, while Dimpy and Bulu, they belong to the whiter space. Now all these characters, the principal characters of Kalin Bhaiya, Munna, Guddu and Bablu, they enjoy the same power structure. But when we talk about your character or Golu's character in the series, they had very limited scope and depth in the first season, and also they rank way below on the power structure compared to these four characters. So now with the second season, will we get to see your character open up like switchblades as it progresses?
Every character is progressing from what they were, and progressing, I mean, in a way where something has happened and how that incident has changed their lives is what we'll see, that how every character deals with it. Mm-hmm. So yeah, that is where we are progressing. And this is, if you are talking about in terms of girls being in a lower power thing and, you know, boys being, but there, this time it's just be giving more weightage to even what girls or women should stand up for things or themselves or whatever. Mm-hmm. So yeah, there is progress in that way. With this one incident, how it affected everybody's life. Mm-hmm.
Okay. And you shared this once that, you know, Atul Munge's sessions helped you transform as an actor. So please help me understand as to, you know, what facets of your personality as an actor did he, you know, polish, you know, so as to enhance the actor in you and add more layers? Did it get to do something with the breathing exercises or calming exercises or something beyond that?
Seems like you've done this workshop.
No, I haven't.
He's a fabulous teacher. So his process of working is from within to out. So he actually, in a way, he worked on me or whatever, or whoever the other people were in the group, and his pattern is that it just changes you as a person. So you're more at peace with yourself. So there were breathing, there were coming to, because as an actor, you're really required to be in that moment. And when I say in the moment, you need to be completely in your present moment to feel that. You can't be thinking about past or future and all that. So that is what he teaches us, to be in our real lives also. That helps you when you are acting. Then, of course, there was breathing, of course, your center. And also what he really talks about is a relaxed actor. So if you are a relaxed actor, then only you be able to perform, or you'll be able to bring out your best. So to be relaxed is what he focuses more on. So, yeah. And it's just that his entire workshop is very, very therapeutic. Mm-hmm. Because it transforms you as a person in your real life, mm-hmm. it also transforms you as an actor on screen.
Mm-hmm. So, you know, does it help you to become more aware of your surroundings as you become more relaxed and, you know, attain?
Of course, when you start concentrating on your breathing and you start enjoying your present and you are in that present moment, mm-hmm. you're obviously more aware about all these things. You start watching yourself away from yourself, like, you know, you see yourself as somebody who's detached from the person, and that's where you can witness the things around, like, you know, now I'm getting anxious. So this is also sort of witnessing the fact that, okay, I am getting anxious. rather than just getting anxious and getting indulging in that feeling, if I can just separate myself from it and see it through. So yeah, I think whatever pattern he has to train you as an actor, it just sort of trains you as a person.
And post the wrap of Satak, there was this phase wherein you didn't have any projects for about a year or so. Please correct me if I'm misinformed. And it was majorly because the projects that were being offered to you were not that satisfactory on a creative level. But now with the pandemic,
and also the projects I wanted to do, I was not getting. So it's also that way. It's not like I was sitting and projects are coming and I'm like, oh, I don't want to do it.
Okay. So, but now, in these era when the entire world is struggling, financially, economically, and with the work, you are getting to do the work of your choice. For example, the dubbing of Mirzapur or the recent commercial that you shot yesterday on your birthday. This uncertainty of life, does it give you a thrill as an actor and, push you to beyond your boundaries?
Of course, it's a thrill and it's like, it's a very happy feeling. And I'm really grateful to my stars or my universe or whatever you call energies and everything that's around you. And I'm glad that I was really at peace and I'm getting to do the work that I want to do. So, yeah, very in a happy, more in a happy situation.
Okay. And with the culture of web series picking up and gaining the momentum in India, do you feel that when it comes to writing our female characters, it's approaching the right direction? The characters today, the female characters have more depth, and they are not just the if I could say like just to add the aesthetic value, they are far beyond that. So do you feel that we are in the right direction when it comes to writing our female characters?
Yes, and I think writing is the most important thing. It's the hero of your film, it's the heroine of your film, it's everything. It's the essence of any project writing. And if you're making, if you're considering women issues or if you're just bringing them, empowering them in the scripts, so it's also coming across and we're really in the right direction as far as the people that I am surrounded with and the kind of scripts that I get to read. So definitely I feel that we are in the right direction and hopefully things are going to get better.
Okay. And with Mirzapur, when it started, when it came to you as a bound script, you were not that much keen on doing the series, but when you met the show creator and the showrunner Karan Anshuman, and the directors also, it sort of changed your perspective towards the series. So does this incongruency between what's written and what's being explained to you, through the creative vision of a creator, how do you, bridge these two together?
I had not read the script or anything before saying that I don't want to do it. It was just a call. Mm-hmm. I, in fact, met them and I realized that I should do it. Mm-hmm. Gurumeet Singh and Karan at that time. Mm-hmm. So I can't really answer this question because I hadn't read anything and then the narration happened. It was only the narration that happened first and followed by the scripts and everything.
And your latest teaser on that you put up on Instagram, it says that, us raat se lekar aaj tak hum roye nahi hai. So in real life also, does bottled up aggression help you eventually develop the grit and achieve a common goal, or like you go with the flow?
No, it doesn't. Like, I really need to get rid of my aggression, or not even aggression, whatever I'm feeling at that time. Mm-hmm. I can't pile things on in my heart. I can't do it. It just gives me anxiety. So it's, I just might as well tell it to someone, that I'm feeling bad or I'm feeling this or I'm feeling that. So I don't think that bottled up aggression takes me anywhere. Mm-hmm. But if I've had bad experience, then I take a note of it and I learn something from it. That I keep it with myself so that in future, I grow above whatever the experiences I've had and I don't have them again in future. So that's what I take care of.
Cool. So with that, we have reached the end of this conversation. I would like to know if there's something that I may have missed asking you as a question. So please feel free to talk about it.
No, it's whatever you want to ask. So I think whatever you wanted to ask, like, it's all good. And I enjoyed the interview.
Thank you so much. So on that note, thank you for talking to us. It was a pleasure having a conversation with you, Harshita. And I wish you all the best for Mirzapur too.
Thank you so much.
Please take care.
You too. Thank you.